Hello friend, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in AutoCAD 2018 Metric. If you have been following along, go and open the file 00_039_BIABM where you save. Go to the Quick Access toolbar and click the Save As icon. This will bring the Save Drawing As dialog box. Rename this file to 00_040_BIABM and click the Save button. Go to the Home tab, Draw Panel, and select the Polyline command. As specified, start point prompt, start the line at the vertex, at this vertex. Use the endpoint object snap and snap to this vertex. Continue to snap until you get to the point where you start. If he snap to the wrong position, type U on your keyboard and press enter to undo the last segment. Use the perpendicular object snap and snap perpendicular to this snap. Press enter to end the line polyline command. Go to the visual style control and change to 2D wireframe. Select this polyline, right click, isolate object. Go to the view cube and click the top. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the fillet command. Fillet this line to this line. Now go to the home tab, draw panel, and select the 2D polyline command. At the specified start point prompt, start a line from this area. Turn on the polar tracking. Make sure that the snap increment is set to 45 degrees. Click into the drawing area to close the window and snap into 45 degrees. Press enter. Press enter to start the line command again. Start from this point and snap into 45 degrees. Press enter. Repeat the polyline command. Snap into 45 degree increment. Press enter. Press enter again to start the command and snap into 45 degree increment. Now select this line. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the copy command. Copy this line from this point to this point, from this point to this point, from this point to this point, to this point. Press escape. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the fillet command. Type M on your keyboard and press enter. Fillet this line to this line. This line to this line. Now select this line and extrude it. Fillet this line to this line. Select this line, go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the mirror command. As specified, first point of mirror line prompt. Use the endpoint object and snap to this point. Now move the mouse cursor and snap to the perpendicular to this line. Press enter. Go to the home tab, draw panel, and select the line command. Snap at the intersection of this line. Move the mouse cursor into this direction and snap to this intersection. Now move the mouse cursor and snap to move it at 135 degree. Click. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the fillet command. Type M on your keyboard and press enter. Fillet this line to this line. 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 Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, draw panel, and select the line command. Draw a line from this endpoint to this endpoint. Press enter. Press enter to repeat line command. Draw a line from this endpoint to this endpoint. Press enter. Now use a window to select all of the objects. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the extrude command. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the trim command. Press enter. Trim off this object. Press escape to get out of the command. Type DI on your keyboard and press enter. At the specified first point prompt, click on this point and move the mouse cursor and click on this point. Hover the mouse cursor at the edge of the screen if you are using Windows 8 and type CAL. Press enter to bring the Windows calculator. If you are using Windows 7, click on the chat box and type CAL to bring the calculator format. Now back to AutoCAD. press F2 and select this figure. Control C, select the calculator, right click and paste, divide this figure by 2 equals to, multiply this figure by 0.75 equals to, right click the figure, copy, back to AutoCAD. Start the line command and specify first point from start the line at this point. Turn on the auto mode and move to the Z, to the positive Z axis. Backspace twice and hold down the control key. Type V on your keyboard to paste the figure. Press enter. Press enter to end the command. Hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Select this line. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the copy command. As specified base point prompt, snap at this base point and copy to this base point. Press escape to get out of the command. Now type DI on your keyboard and press enter. At the specified first point prompt, click on this corner and use the perpendicular object snap to snap to this corner. Type F2 on your keyboard and copy this figure. Control C to copy it. Go to the calculator, right click and paste. Multiply this figure by 0.75 equals to, right click, copy. Go to the home tab, drop an and select the line command. At specify first point prompt, click on this point, move the mouse cursor up, backspace twice, and hold down the control key, type V on your keyboard to paste the figure. Press enter. Press enter to end the line command. Select this line. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the copy command. At specify base point prompt, use the endpoint object snap and snap to this point. Move the mouse cursor and snap to this point. Press escape to get out of the command. Type DI on your keyboard and press enter. Measure the distance from this line perpendicular to or midpoint of this line. Press the F2 key on your keyboard. Select this figure. Hold down the control key and type letter C to copy. Select the calculator. Right click. Paste. Multiply this figure 0.75 equals to. Right click the figure, copy, back to AutoCAD, select the line command, and specify base point prompt, click on this area, move the mouse cursor up and backspace twice, hold down the control key and type V on your keyboard to paste the figure, press enter to end the command, select this line, go to the home tab, modify panel and select the copy command, use this as a base point and copy this line into new location, press escape to get out of the command. Now go to the home tab, draw panel and select the 3D polyline command. As specified first point prompt, click on this area and click on this area. Type C on the keyboard and press enter. Press enter to repeat the command again. Click at this endpoint, this point, type C on the keyboard and press enter. Click start the command again. Click on this point, this point, this point, this point, type C on your keyboard and press enter. Start the command again. Click on this point, this point, this point, this point, type C on your keyboard to close the figure. Start the command again. Click on this point, this point, this point, this point, type C on your keyboard to close the figure. Start the command again. Click on this point, this point, this point, this point. Type C to close the figure. Hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Press enter to repeat the 3D polyline command. Click on this point, this point, this point. Type C to close the figure. Now let's convert these other objects into surface. Now select this polyline, go to the 3D tools tab, surface panel and select the plan surface, go to the visual control and select realistic, select this 3D polyline, go to the 3D tools tab, surface panel and click the plan, select this 3D surface and select the plan. We'll find out what makes this 3D surface isn't converted to a surface. Now select this surface, this polyline, 3D polyline, and this 3D polyline. Go to the 3D tools tab, surface panel, and click the plan. Select this surface, convert it to a plan. Again, this guy isn't working well. Now we're going to use another method to solve this problem. Select the surface, right click, select similar, right click, hide object. Now we need to correct these guys. Select this surface, this 3D solid, hit delete key. Select this and hit delete key. Select this, hit delete key. Select this and hit delete key. Now go to the home tab, drop an and select line command, and specify start point prompt. Start the line from this point and arrow the and move the line into this direction. Press enter. Start the line command. Start it from this point and snap perpendicular to this line. Now move to the top of this line. Press escape. Select this line. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the move command. Use the endpoint object snap and pick this line from this point and move it into this endpoint. Now go to the 3D tools tab, modeling panel, and select the extrude command. Select this line, press enter, move the mouse cursor into this direction and click. Now right click, isolate end object isolation. Select this surface and this surface. Go to the 3D tools tab, surface panel, and select the trim command. Select this surface and this surface, press enter. Trim off this surface. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select this surface, select the 3D polyline, select the surface, zoom into this area and select the line, right click, select similar, select this surface, right click, isolate objects. Select the surface and this surface, right click, select similar, hit delete on your keyboard. Now go to the home tab, draw panel, and select the line command. Draw a line from this point and snap perpendicular to this point. Press escape, press enter, start the line command. Start a line from this point and snap perpendicular to this point. Now move and snap at the top of this vertex. Press escape, select this line, go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the move command. And specify base point prompt, use the endpoint object and snap from this line, and move the mouse cursor and snap to this line. Now type oops on your keyboard to bring back the object that we delete. Hold down the shift key and the middle mouse button to orbit. Select this line, go to the 3D tools tab, modeling panel, select the extrude command, move the mouse cursor and snap to the endpoint of this line. Go to the 3D tools tab, surface panel, and select the trim surface command. Add the select surface origin to trim from, select the surface that you want to trim and press enter. And select curve surface origin, select the surface that you want to be as a cutting edge and press enter. Trim the surface. Press escape to get out of the command. Select the trim surface command again. Select this surface, press enter. And select this surface, press enter. Trim off this surface. I think the surface is in the associativity is current. Now, go to the home tab, surface panel, and select the trim command. Change the workspace to 3D modeling. Go to the surface tab and edit panel, select the trim command. select this surface and this surface, press enter, select this surface, press enter, trim off this surface, press escape, select the trim command, select this surface, press enter, select this surface, press enter, trim off this surface. Now press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the line command. Start a line from this point and snap to the perpendicular to this line. Now move the line and snap to the end point of this vertical line. Press escape to get out of the command. Select the line, go to the home tab, modify panel and select the move command. And specify base point front. Select this line and move the line into this end point. Select this line, go to the home tab, modeling panel and select the extrude command, extrude this line to this corner, press escape, go to the surface tab, edit panel and select the trim command, select this surface, press enter, select this surface, press enter, trim off this surface and this surface. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select this surface, right click, select similar, select this surface, right click, select similar, right click, isolate objects. Now go to the home tab, go to the surface tab, edit panel and select the trim command. Use a window selection to select the entire surface, press enter. Use a window selection again and press enter. Now trim off the unwanted surface. Press enter to end the command. Press enter to repeat the command again. Select this surface, this surface, this surface, this surface. Press enter. Select this surface, this, this, this. Press enter. Click on this area to get rid of this excess surface. Now zoom to what are the underside of the surface. The underside is okay. Now select the entire surface, go to the home tab, layer panel and move this object to R3. Right click in the drawing area, isolate, end object isolation. Go to the home tab, layer panel and click the freeze layer command. Select this object, press escape to get out of the command. Use a window selection and select this construction line. Hit delete on your keyboard. Go to the home tab, layer panel, and select the tall layer button. This brings back your model. Alright, let's end this video here. We'll continue to model our roof in the next tutorial. If you find this tutorial useful, please click the like button and share it to your friends. If you have any question or you want a specific tutorial, please leave a comment below. If you want to continue on this series or any other tutorial on my channel, please subscribe. Thanks very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next class. Goodbye.